Excessive sweating, otherwise known as hyperhidrosis, causes your body to sweat more than it needs to. It currently affects 3% of adults in the US, but remember, sweating is normal and healthy, especially when your body temperature rises, like when you're exercising, in order to cool you down. You need to sweat, but sometimes our bodies sweat in overdrive. This could be from our armpits, hands, face, feet, and in areas where we have a lot of skin folds. In this video, we will look at the two types of excessive sweating, what causes it and why it occurs. We'll also talk about ways to manage it and the options that are available to us. So stay with me till the end. Also, real quick, guys, before we get started, it would mean the world to me if you hit the like button down below for the YouTube algorithm and turn the bell on next to it to stay up to date with new weekly videos. So let's talk about what is going on and why you're sweating this much. But to do that, we need some visuals. So basically, you're getting an overstimulation of cholinergic receptors located on what are known as eccrine glands involving acetylcholine. You'll sweat beyond what the body uses for homeostatic temperature regulation, which is controlled by the hypothalamus, which means you sweat more than what is needed of you to keep you at a normal temperature. And the location of your eccrine glands are concentrated in areas such as the armpits, palms, soles, and the face. And we have about 2 to 4 million sweat glands, which all contribute to thermoregulation. Approximately 80% of them are eccrine sweat glands, like the ones we mentioned. These secretions are more watery. Then you have the remaining 20% that are apocrine sweat glands, which are responsible for thicker excretions with an unpleasant odor. The exact cause, you might ask, for this imbalance, we don't fully understand yet, but the current hypothesis is that there's a dysfunction of the autonomic system nerve fibers. And there are two types of hyperhidrosis, primary and secondary hyperhidrosis. With primary hyperhidrosis, it's episodic and genetic. It's not the result of another health condition, which means it comes and goes and is often associated with specific triggers, which can be feeling certain emotions, stress, or just nervousness. And it usually happens in the daytime and disappears when you're asleep. You'll get the classic sweaty stains on clothing, shoes, can even feel wet. The paper you touch gets wet, and you can actually have extremely wet handshakes. The secondary hyperhidrosis is from a result of something else, like a fever, an overactive thyroid, gout, and even maybe menopause. It can also be a side effect of a supplement or anything else that is said to increase your acetylcholine. And if you're not sure if you have it, there are two popular tests that you could take. One is the paper test, where your provider places a special paper on the affected area to absorb the sweat. Later on, they will weigh the paper to see how much sweat you have. Or two, they do a starch iodine test, where they apply iodine solution to the area and sprinkle starch over the iodine. And in places where you have excessive sweating, the solution actually turns dark blue, which is a really cool way to identify it. Or three, what's really fancy, is the vapometer that looks like this. It measures transepidermal water loss and also measures the amount of sweat you're producing, which can provide even more details. So assuming you have excessive sweating, what are some ways to go about it? We know what it is, why it occurs, the two types of hyperhidrosis. We need to look at the first thing to do, which is your antiperspirants. These are going to temporarily plug up your sweat ducts and reduce sweating. The clinical strength one by Certain Dri is one that you can get over the counter. It contains 25% aluminum chlorohydrate, which is the highest one I've seen. They also have a fragrance-free roll-on deodorant with 12% aluminum chloride that lasts up to 72 hours and works on odor and sweating. And it works at this very location here. And you might be thinking, why aluminum? Well, it creates one of the best salt blockages because of its size in relation to the acrosyringium on the actual eccrine gland. I know aluminum deodorants get a lot of bad rap these days, but for the very case of hyperhidrosis, we only use it because it's the right key to the right lock. Aluminum-free deodorants are designed to absorb the sweat, not block it at the base, so expect them to wear off very fast. The American Cancer Society even said that issue with aluminum-based deodorants were just a rumor because of small case studies, and that there are no strong epidemiological studies in people that link breast cancer risk and antiperspirant use, and very little scientific evidence to support this claim. And the best way to use them is at night, so that you can block the sweating. Use an antiperspirant every single night for 3 weeks, gradually decreasing it to 3 times a week. But here's the thing, if you're experiencing irritation with them, then you can wipe off the antiperspirants first thing in the morning. Secondly, Anytime throughout the day, try applying witch hazel. Witch hazel is an astringent and also an antiperspirant. It dries your skin as well as closes the pores to prevent sweaty underarms. You can directly apply it to the sweaty areas of your body or mix it with water to make a paste that you can actually leave on for at least 60 minutes before washing it off with water. If you've tried all the different forms of aluminum products, because remember, you might have to find a salt version that works for your body. There's aluminum zirconium, aluminum cisquichlorohydrate, aluminum chloride, aluminum chlorohydrate, aluminum formate. There's a lot. You're going to have to try them for a week or two to see noticeable results. And let's say you've tried witch hazel and you think you need something stronger than what's commercially available. Then talk to your doctor about Hubrexa. They're an individually wrapped cloth that contains glypyronium tosylate that is proven to reduce underarm sweating. Make sure you're washing your hands immediately after with soap and water to prevent spreading it to unwanted places. So that's the first option. Then there are options like anticholinergics, like oxybutynin, which of course, we could go back to the diagram, you can see that it works here. Our aluminum products work at the end of the pathway, but oxybutynin works closer to the start. Most people don't like using it because it can lead to dry eyes, dry mouth, urinary retention, and even constipation. These options are sometimes coupled up with something called iontophoresis, which we have been using since actually the 1940s, which is pretty cool. Essentially, you have an iontophoresis device, which is a machine that generates a low voltage current. The device temporarily shuts down your sweat glands. Isn't that interesting? You'll dip your hands or feet in a pan of shallow water, which carries an electrical current. And for the other body parts, your provider will place pads that connect to the machine on your skin, which I found really cool. I haven't seen it done in person, but some have said it helped them a lot. The sixth thing is actually getting botulinum toxin, which is a treatment with botulinum toxin or Botox that blocks the nerves that trigger the sweat glands, specifically by cleaving the SNAP25 protein. It's temporary though, so it'll only work for 3 to 6 months at a time. And for more permanent solutions, sometimes it's going to require liposuction of the gland, but that's for like a last result. Microwave therapy, where the sweat glands are destroyed, doing this will actually stop the excessive sweating immediately, but these are last resort cases. And since about 2% of the sweat glands in the body are located in the underarm area, destroying them will not affect the body's ability to cool off, just FYI. You're still able to cool off without them. In addition to all of these solutions, there are some things I want you to avoid. Because remember, a lot of the times it comes down to lifestyle factors too, like your diet. You want to be eating healthier. In fact, some anecdotal reports even mention how chlorophyll and celery juice can help with body odor. And with that said, one, avoid blended fabrics and polyester. These trap heat and make you sweat more. Wear breathable clothing like cotton, which can actually help you feel more comfortable if you sweat. If it's your feet, then make sure to alternate your shoes. Don't wear cotton socks, wear moisture wicking ones, and try wearing leather shoes. Your shoes have a lot to do with this. Two, don't avoid daily showering. You want to create a consistent showering schedule, so it's okay to shower every day if you sweat a lot. And always wait 1 hour after your shower to put on your clothes. Don't put your clothes on right away. Three, several chemicals including caffeine, guarana, and geranium can increase sweat production. Reduce your intake of coffee, tea, and most importantly, energy drinks if you do sweat a lot. Four, make sure you are active. Physical exercise can actually help regulate your sweating and affect your autonomic function. A lot of people stop exercising, but there's really no need to. Five, which I found really interesting, avoid cumin. And that's according to the American Academy of Dermatology, not me. But I'm more curious to hear from you guys though. What are your thoughts on excessive sweating? Do you have any tips and tricks that has worked for you? Leave them in the comments below. Let's have a discussion. And until then, guys, I'll see you on the next one.